Hi everyone, welcome to the third in the series of Take a Walk with Peter, and today we're talking about using translations and abbreviations in the class and characteristics. As many of you know, characteristics in SAP are limited to 30 characters. If you're using S4, then you can actually flick a switch and increase that so that you can use up to 70 characters. These characteristics can be of different types. They can be just pure alphanumeric, they can be numeric with units of measure, but they can also be what's called allowable value type characteristics. Allowable value characteristics allow you to provide drop-down lists, selected list of values that can only be the ones that are used for those characteristics. And we normally recommend that you actually set your characteristics to that, because then what you can do is now you can start defining standardized content, actual standardized values that go into the characteristics. You can also set these allowable values up to be multilingual. So you can now actually set up English, French, Spanish, for instance, so that when you actually create descriptions going forward, depending on the login language, you can enter characteristic values in your login language and automatically create descriptions in the other languages that you're using in your system, right? So I think it's a very important aspect to consider when you're setting your system up, to make sure that you're using these allowable values. It gives you structure, not only structure of the material description, but also standardized content that's going into that structure. So I hope that's been a useful tip for when you're setting your system up. What we will do in the next episode is I'll actually spend some time and answer a very, very important question, which is, what is the best time of the day to go for a walk? So stay tuned for the next episode of Take a Walk with Peter.